Thank you for downloading LiveWall's SketchUp Design Kit. At LiveWall, we try to make your job as a designer easy with ready-to-use SketchUp dynamic components. So, what are SketchUp components? SketchUp components are groups of geometry, edges, and faces that anyone can assemble in SketchUp. They're like little models within your main model, and they can represent anything: furniture, plants, vehicles, anything. In the LiveWall design model, this browser includes the components VertiRail, GutterRail, RainRail, and the Walter. What are dynamic components? Dynamic components are SketchUp components to which attributes have been assigned. Attributes can be simple pieces of extra information like part number, cost, and weight. Attributes can also contain spatial relationships, like how two parts are positioned relative to each other, and behaviors, like animation and smart scaling. Some dynamic components are very simple, and some are very complex. A door which can be configured into 1,000 different combinations, and which swings open and closed when you click on it. For live wall dynamic components, product identification, SKUs, and parametric values, such as dimension and colors, have been assigned to components to facilitate the design process. So why use live wall dynamic components? First, SketchUp is user-friendly and is free. Second, SketchUp is a great presentation tool. Massing studies and concept designs can be generated and displayed with efficiency and with professional quality. Third, once a live wall design is complete, it can be exported for use in construction documents. How can I access live wall dynamic components? 1. Download the zip file from the live wall website. 2. Extract the folder and find the LiveWall SKP file. 3. Open file and explore the provided LiveWall components. An 8-foot by 8-foot mock-up of the LiveWall system has been set up as a starting point for design. The vertical spacing between rain rails is 12 inches. The standard Walter is 6 inches deep, and all module widths are consistent at either 8 inches or 16 inches. How do you use dynamic components? Dynamic components work in different ways based upon what the designer wants them to do. As a rule, the dynamic component attributes are set up to lay out walls from the bottom right to the top left. To create a custom component, access the component options. Using the component options dialog box, you can configure a component by choosing options from lists and typing in dimensions and numbers. Keep in mind that only some dynamic components are connected to the component options dialog box. Live wall components such as fasteners, nozzles, and end caps are examples of embedded components that have limited attributes. To edit a component, click on it so that it is highlighted. Individual live wall components should be edited in the following order: 1. VertiRails, 2. GutterRail, 3. RainRails, 4. Walter modules. Follow instructions for the chosen components options. There is also a live wall dynamic component that builds all the pieces simultaneously. Live wall dynamic components are set up to delete pieces with the Interact tool. The Interact tool can be found in the dynamic toolbar and under the Tools menu. Using the Interact tool, you can click on a component to make it do what it's set up to do: animate, go to a scene, etc. If a dynamic component is set up to react to the Interact tool, the Interact tool cursor will change its appearance when you move over the component. If you're using Google SketchUp Pro, you can edit the underlying attributes of existing dynamic components or create new ones by using the Component Attributes dialog box. There are a few tips to consider when designing a live wall project. Irrigation and chase components are not included. Plan for irrigation and leave gaps of 8 inches for stacked valve configurations or 12 inches for inline valve configurations where needed to accommodate for feeder lines, valves, and pressure regulator. Remember that the live wall system is designed for irrigation runs of 64 linear feet or less per valve. Diagrams of typical irrigation configurations are shown in the live wall design guide for your use. VertiRails. Be sure to place the first VertiRail at a minimum of 4 inches above the finished grade. Rail spacing is typically 16 inches or 24 inches OC. At 16-inch spacing, 6 vertirails will be needed for every 8-foot rain rail section. At 24-inch spacing, 4 vertirails will be needed for every 8-foot rain rail section. Determine the framing for your structure and choose the appropriate spacing from the component options. Vertirails come in 8-foot standard lengths and accommodate 8 rain rails for the standard system. Keep this in mind when planning for vertical alignments around building openings. The vertirails can be adjusted in 1-inch increments to accommodate for custom vertical alignments not arriving at the 8-foot standard height. Gutter rails and standard rain rails. For typical 16-inch vertirail spacing, all 8-foot rain rail sections are aligned with 8-inch overhangs on each end, measured from center of vertirail. For typical 24-inch vertirail spacing, all 8-foot rain rail sections are aligned with 12-inch overhangs on each end, measured from center of vertirail. Any lengths not in multiples of 8 feet can be accommodated at the end of run by adjusting the last rail's length to a dimension divisible in 16-inch increments. Be sure to designate a suitable location for stormwater discharge. A 2-inch pre-drilled hole will be required in the bottom of the gutter rain rail at a chosen location to accommodate a gutter drain. Wall Ter Rows with modules of 16 inches only. For a standard 8-foot rail length, 6 modules will be required. For an 8-foot high section of the standard Wall Ter system, 4 rows of 16-inch modules will be required. Any lengths not in multiples of 8 feet can be accommodated at the end of run by adjusting the number of 16-inch modules. Component options take into account the vertical alignment differences between the two systems. Wall Ter Rows with modules of 8 inches and 16 inches. For a standard 8-foot rail length, 5 16-inch modules and 2 8-inch modules will be required. For an 8-foot high section of the standard Wall Ter system, 4 rows will be required. Component options take into account the vertical alignment of the system. At LiveWall, we know efficiency in the design process leads to a better overall product. Hopefully, this design tool will assist in translating your great design into a successful installation.